Hello friends, this is ASM Oral's question and answer series. This set is specifically for JB Singh, part 5. Let's begin. What is the significance of damage control plan? What are its content? The damage control plan, as required by SOLAS Chapter 2 Regulation 1/19, is intended to provide a ship's officer with clear information on ship's watertight subdivision and provide a ship's officer with clear information on ship's watertight subdivision and equipment related to maintaining the boundaries and effectiveness of the subdivision, so that in the event of damage to the ship causing flooding, proper precautions can be taken to prevent progressive flooding and effective action can be taken to mitigate and recover ship's loss of stability. As per MSC Circular 1245, the following are the items to be included in damage control plan. Number 1, watertight boundaries of the ship. Number 2, location and arrangement of cross flooding system and means to correct it, along with the location of all valves and remotes of the system. Number 3, location of all internal watertight closing appliances. Number 4, location of all shell doors. Number 5, location of all external watertight closing appliances. Number 6, location of all bilge and ballast pumps and associated valves. Next question, why is damage control plan important on passenger ships? Damage control plans are important on passenger ships because passenger ships have more watertight doors on the ship. Next question, what are the stability criteria for cargo ships? There is a separate video that I made comparing the intact stability of various kind of ships. The link to that video is attached in the description. Next question, what is the difference between towage and salvage? When does towage become salvage? The main difference between towage and salvage are as follows. Number 1, need of contract. Under towage, the right of a towing vessel to payment depends on contract, whether express or implied. This is not the case in salvage, which does not depend on contract and indeed may be rewarded even though the master of the salvage vessel has expressly declined the offer of assistance. Number 2, no cure, no pay. The need for success is a characteristic of salvage but not of towage. Number 3, absence of lien. There is no maritime lien upon the tow for payment of a fixed price by the towage contract, whereas a salver has maritime lien over the property salved. Number 4, danger. While a situation of danger does not preclude a mere towage contract, the element of danger is crucial to a successful salvage claim. Number 5, voluntariness. The service rendered must be voluntary character, that is, not under any contractual or official duty to render assistance in case of salvage. There is an implied duty in towage contract that during the course of towage, if due to some unforeseen peril the tow is placed in danger, the towage may change to salvage. For example, difficulty caused due to breakage of towage wire due to rough seas does not change the towage to salvage. However, if the towed vessel is struck by another vessel or is damaged by an unknown underwater obstruction and is in peril, then towage will change to salvage. Next question, what is a code? A code is a systematic and comprehensive compilation of laws, rules and regulations that are consolidated and classified according to subject matter. Codes may be mandatory like ASM code, IMDG code, or non-mandatory like timber deck cargo code. Next question, when can the certificate of class be cancelled? Class may be suspended following a decision made by society when one or more of the following occurs. When the ship is not operated in compliance with the rule requirements. When the ship proceeds to sea with less freeboard than that assigned. When the owner fails to request a survey after having detected defects and damages affecting the class. When repairs, alterations or conversions affecting the class are carried out without requesting the attendance of surveyor. In addition, class is automatically suspended when the class renewal special survey has not been completed by its due date or within the time granted in special circumstances for completion of the survey. Unless the ship is under attendance by the society surveyor with a view to completion prior to resuming trading. When the annual or intermediate survey has not been completed, by the end of corresponding survey time windows. Suspension of class with respect to the above cases will remain in effect until such time as the due survey or any other survey deemed appropriate by the society has been completed. In addition to the circumstances for which automatic suspension may apply, the class of a ship will be subject to suspension procedures following a decision of the society. When a recommendation class of condition is not dealt with within the time specified, unless it is postponed before the due date by agreement with the society. When one or more other surveys are not held by their due dates or the dates stipulated by the society, also taking into account any extension granted. When, due to the nature of reported defects, the society considers that a ship is not entitled to retain its class even on a temporary basis, like pending necessary repairs or renewals, etc. In other circumstances where the owner fails to submit the ship to a survey in accordance with the special requirement. In all cases, suspension will remain in effect until such time as matters are rectified and classes reinstated or classes withdrawn. Depending on the society's procedure, the suspension of class, which are not automatic, may take effect either when they are decided by the society or from the date when condition for the suspension occurred. However, once the condition for class, suspension or withdrawn are met and before any decision by the society can be taken, either because the society is not aware of the circumstances, like survey dates, etc. are recorded but not systematically monitored, or because the decision is not yet taken, maintenance of class cannot generally be confirmed by the society during this period. The society will withdraw the class of a ship when requested by the owner. The class has been suspended for more than 6 months. The ship is reported as constructive total loss, and the owner does not advise his intention to repair the ship for reinstatement of class. The ship is reported lost. The ship will not trade further as declared by its owner. Withdrawal of class takes effect from the date on which circumstances causing such withdrawal occur or when it is decided. Notification of suspension or withdrawal. When class is suspended or withdrawn, the society will at the same time inform the owner, flag administration and underwriters, and they will publish the information on its website and convey the information to appropriate databases, EQUASIS, etc. Next question, define abandoned ship as per IMO. When will you abandon the ship? I will consider abandoning a ship when an imminent danger of foundering, breaking up, fire or explosion exists, or any other circumstances that endangers the lives of my crew if they remain on board. Next question, loaded VLCC in nighttime in Malacca Strait, what lights to be displayed? Apart from the usual masthead lights, side lights, stern light, there'll be three all-round red lights in a vertical line for the vessel constrained by draft. Next question, how to berth starboard side when there is a current from behind in narrow channel? Basically, in all such questions, you use the anchor to turn around the ship, head into the current and go alongside. Next question, what is SDR? SDR stands for Special Drawing Rights. It is defined and maintained by International Monetary Fund, IMF. The value of SDR is defined by weighted currency basket of 5 major currencies now. US dollars, Great Britain pounds, Euro, Japanese yen, and now also Chinese yuan. Next question, define investigation and casualty. A marine casualty is an event that results in death or serious injury in connection with the operation of a ship, loss of person from a ship, loss or presumed loss or abandonment of a ship, material damage to the ship, stranding or disabling or collision, material damage caused in connection to the operation of a ship, damage to environment. Code for investigation of marine casualties and incidents as amended by IMO Resolution 884-21 and 849-20. Casualty code takes into account UNCLOS Article 94, which is flag state shall hold inquiry into certain casualties and investigation on high seas, and UNCLOS Article 2, which is when casualty occurs in territorial waters or internal waters of the state has a right to investigate. Aim of the Marine Casualty Code: to promote common approach to the investigation of marine casualties and incident, to promote cooperation between states in identifying contributing factors leading to marine casualties, to aid remedial action, to enhance safety of seafarers and passengers, and to protect the marine environment. Next question: how will you know that your ship is overloaded? I will know that my ship is overloaded when my load line is submerged into the salt water. To whom all is a master responsible? A master is responsible to the owner, his crew, flag state of the vessel, the government issuing his certificate of competency, and the port state. Next question: you see two red lights right ahead. Action: two red lights in a vertical line may indicate a vessel not under command that is stopped and drifting. I will check the tide strength and direction and pass the NUC vessel upstream so that the NUC vessel doesn't drift to me. I will also slow down. Define collision. As per American Law Dictionary, collision is an act of a ship or vessel striking together. As per Justice Bingham, collision, when used alone without other words, mean two navigable things coming in contact. Next question: what is common between Hague, Hague-Visby and Hamburg rules? The commonality is that all are carriage of good by sea acts. How do you define a vessel in need of assistance? As per IMO Resolution A949, Session 23, Place of Refuge, a ship in need of assistance means a ship in a situation, apart from one requiring rescue of person on board, that could give rise to loss of a vessel or an environmental or navigational hazard. Next question: difference between GRT and GT. GT stands for gross tonnage. It is a unitless index related to a ship's overall internal volume. It is a function of the volume of all the ship's enclosed spaces measured to the outside of the ship's hull framing. GRT, gross registered tonnage, represents the total internal volume of a vessel, where a registered ton is equal to a volume of 100 cubic feet, which if filled with fresh water would weigh around 2.8 metric tons. GRT was replaced by GT in 1994 under Tonnage Measurement Convention of 1969 and is no longer a widely used term in the industry. Next question: what is the infringement of master's overriding authority? As per the ASM code, the safety management system should ensure that master has overriding authority and responsibility to make decisions with respect to safety and pollution prevention, and to request the company's assistance as may be necessary. Next question on OLB entries. The following entries should be made in the official logbook: every conviction by a legal tribunal and punishment inflicted, every offence committed by a member of crew and subsequent action taken, same to be read and acknowledged by crew member or refusal to acknowledge to be put down, report of quality of work by crew, illness, death, birth, marriage, sign-on sign-off, wages due to a deceased seaman, personal effects of dead seaman, record of all drills, muster, emergency training, instruction, or inspection of LSA, FFA, record of occasions on which lifeboats were swung out and lowered, records of test, drills, and inspection of steering gear, weekly inspection of accommodation and the result, change of command, record of promotions on board, every case in which allowance of provision is reduced along with relevant details, every case of drunkenness or misconduct on the part of any certified mate or engineer, whether or not the case is investigated, every important accident or damage to the ship or cargo. Next question: how are IMO numbers designated? IMO ship identification number are assigned by IHS Fairplay. The IMO number is assigned to a hull during construction, generally upon keel laying. Next question: what all certificates are there pertaining to ASM code, document of compliance, and safety management certificate? Next question: what all certificates change when owners change with reference to ASM, document of compliance, safety management certificate? I hope it was a useful video for you. please comment with your feedback. Thank you for watching.